Holy crap. Hopefully that introduction didn't spook you guys too much, but this is quite possibly the coolest thing that I have ever seen built in Unturned, ever. Now, don't get me wrong, I've seen my fair share of huge bases and mobile fortresses, but this massive drivable pirate ship takes the cake easily. Built by the members of the Mandalorians clan in just over 3 hours off of a forest APC, this pirate ship can be driven around in the ocean thanks to the most recent update's addition to the APC, giving it amphibious qualities. Now, this also means that it can drive on land too, but let's just say that's because it's a magic pirate ship, okay? Now, instead of listing all the features it has, perhaps I should just give you a tour of the three decks instead. I mean, that sounds good, so let's get right into it. Now, currently I am out in the middle of, well, that's Taylor Beach over there, and I'm out here in the middle enjoying the clouds. I did adjust the lighting and the clouds and stuff of PI to give it a little bit more of a theme of pirates, I guess, because on the original PI, it's too bright and happy, and pirates are spooky, so I wanted to make it a little bit spooky. But anyway, so up here on top of the main deck, I don't know what the ship terms are, so please don't hurt me. Up here is where the nice little square steering wheel is, where you can steer the ship. That's not actually where you control the ship, but I will show you where you actually control it in a little bit. But this is kind of the main deck area up here. And man, this place, it's just huge. Oh, it's so great. So there are a total of 6 cannons on this ship. Not functional, but here's what they look like. Nice little cannons. I just think it's so cool how this ship is actually swaying back and forth as if it's in the water. I mean, well, it is in the water, but as if it's like a real ship. Because before this update, things were always stationary. And this is something that you can actually drive around like it's a real ship. And that's because it's built off the APC, of which is floating in the water right now. And because of that, the APC is kind of bobbing back and forth, and so is the ship. And it actually creates a nice bobbing ship motion. And it's so cool. It's so cool. There are 3 masts on this ship. There's this little thing here and this thing right there. All of which you can climb up the ladders, by the way. You can climb up to the top of this and you can get a nice view from up here. It's just a little bit difficult because the ship is swaying back and forth. And then there's the same one right there. And then there's the main mast here, which is like the main center focal point of this pirate ship. Just looks fantastic. Look at that. Made obviously out of large birch plates. This is just the main sail, I should say. And it's connected to the main mast here by a bunch of maple pipes, like so. Same with up at the top over there. And then, of course, you can climb up this main little mast here. You gotta be a little bit careful because the ship is swaying back and forth. Oh, almost fell off. There we go. Once you make it up to the top, there is a nice little observatory up here, so you can get some nice binoculars. You can look out for icebergs and such. Oh, wait, no, this is a pirate ship. This isn't Titanic. But you can look out for other pirate ships or ships that you would like to steal and inform the captain down there. Well, the captain's gonna be down there, but I'll show you. Now that's everything on the main deck. Now let's move inside into the captain's quarters in here. Aha, check this out. So you do have a staircase down to the second floor of the ship right here, but we're gonna focus on everything in the captain's quarters. We have nice storage areas in here. By the way, all of the storage containers in here do not have anything in them. So like there's nothing to see here. There's nothing to see here. And in here is where the captain sleeps. He's got a nice little chair desk setup thing here. And then of course you have the bed right there where the captain sleeps, and I'm gonna claim that because I am the captain now. Moving on downstairs, there are 2 different ways you can go downstairs. There's the central staircase in the middle, and then there's also the staircase from the captain's quarters right here. There's also a ladder to get up from the second floor. And here is the main deck where all of the cannons and the rum and the other stuff that ships have in storage? I don't know. There's also a nice little dining table back here with some tipped over chairs. People got a little bit drunk. And yeah, I mean, that's the main floor right here. Moving on down to the crew area on the bottom floor, there is only one way down there, this little hole right here, and it's a ladder. And down here, it's the not the most pleasant place to be, because it's the crew area. This is where the people who are not the captain sleep. And it's a little bit flooded in here. That's because this is where the APC sits itself. And of course, the water is going to be a little bit higher than the APC itself. There are a bunch of beds in here, which actually are probably in the best position of anything. You know, like the bed up there is easily exposed to people shooting RPGs at the back of the ship, and it might blow up the bed back there. So the crew really get the best treatment by having their beds down here. But there are a few crates in here, nice little supports in here, and then of course the APC itself, which you can get in and use to drive around. Now you guys might be wondering, how the heck are you supposed to be able to drive this thing without being able to see out of it, even in first person or in third person? Well, if you are an admin, then you can just use camera controls and you can position the camera like so, and then be able to drive the ship around like this. Like, it actually looks like you're in third person driving a ship of this size. It's so cool. Now, what if you are not an admin and you don't have access to camera controls? Well, in that case, you would be driving the ship around like this, and you would actually need to use the coordination of your team members or your crew members to communicate with you in regards to what direction you should be moving. Alright, so we're going to park the ship right here just temporarily. It's going to be a little shaky just for a little bit, but eventually it calms down and you're able to walk around a lot easier. Ah, yes, and one thing that I did forget, and possibly one of the most important aspects of the pirate ship, is the plank. Yes, you can walk the plank. You can do it indeed. You can tell all of your prisoners to walk the plank. You can hold like a katana to their head, and then you force them to jump off the ship. That would be super cool as well. But yeah, that really is like everything regarding this pirate ship. Now this is obviously, very clearly, as you can tell, huge. So it is very intensive for your computer to run this. I mean, I myself am getting 23 frames per second right now, so you might need to lower down your settings if they aren't already in order to be able to play this even in single player, to be able to play around with this pirate ship easily, I suppose. But yes, this is amazing. I really do hope you guys enjoyed this pirate ship. Now this is available for download by you guys, so if you guys would like to download this ship, be sure to go down in the description down below and you can drag all of those files within the zip folder into the location on the screen right now. But anyway, that was the pirate ship in Unturned, created by the members of the Mandalorians clan. Be sure to check out their Steam group in the description down below as well. They might be creating more awesome things in the future, so be sure to check them out. But anyway, that's everything I have for now. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to rate, comment, subscribe, and do all that gibberish, because me like big bull is out.